Now that we know all the operations, let's go ahead and try some more complicated examples using order of operations. Now, first of all, remember the acronym for the operations, the order of operations, and it's this: G, E, M/D, and A/S. Now, G stands for grouping. That's an R, O-U-P-I-N-G, grouping symbols. Now, grouping symbols can come in lots of different flavors, right? They could be parentheses, or brackets, or absolute value, or the square root symbol, for example, or the cube root or the fourth root, and so on, as we'll see later on. E stands for exponential expressions. M and D is multiplication and division from left to right, and A and S are addition and subtraction from left to right. So, looking at this problem, I see, well, lots going on, right? But the first thing that jumps out at me are grouping symbols, the brackets. Now, these parentheses are not considered grouping symbols because with parentheses, if there's nothing to do inside them, all they're doing is simply either denoting multiplication or being used as the base for an exponential expression. Here, they're just denoting multiplication. There's nothing to do inside them. But the brackets are grouping symbols. So remember how this goes. Within G, that is within G of GEMDAS, we apply the order of operation. So all of this, I run through GEMDAS again. So no exponential expressions inside the G, inside the grouping symbol, right? Even though there's an exponential expression here, you don't do that because we're working within G. So no E. M and multiplication and division from left to right. Multiplication right here. So this is what I'm going to do first. This multiplication precedes that exponentiation because this falls within the land of G, grouping symbols. Okay, now the key to these problems is not jumping ahead and writing the answer. Even though you're focusing on this, you still write everything down left to right until you get to what you're interested in. So I'm just going to write that down. Here we go. It's going to be negative 2, bracket, or parentheses, negative 3 squared, minus 5. You see how nothing's changed? Bracket, negative 2. Okay, now, this multiplication, what you can do on this is, even though this is subtraction, there's a little trick you can use, and you can take the subtraction symbol and sort of attach it mentally to the 4, and think of negative 4 multiplied by negative 6. And when you do that, let's see, negative 4 times negative 6 is positive 24. But there's one little cost of doing that. When you do that, what was here becomes addition. Okay, so let me repeat what I just said. I'm thinking of the negative as going with the 4, and in its place, there comes an addition symbol. Okay, and then negative 4 times negative 6 is positive 24. Okay, and then we keep going, right? Now it's addition within G still, so negative 2 plus 24 is 22. So negative 2 times negative 3 quantity squared, or just rather negative 3 squared, minus 5, and negative 2 plus 24 is 22. And I need parentheses 22, because it's still multiplication right here. Okay, now I'm done with G. These parentheses are no longer grouping symbols because there's nothing to do inside them. Move on to E, exponential expressions, right there. Negative 3 squared is 9. So it's going to be negative 2 times 9, right? Because this is still multiplication. And then minus 5 times 22. And now we're finished with E. We move on to M, multiplication and division from left to right. So there's no division, but there certainly is multiplication from left to right. So negative 2 times 9 is negative 18. Okay, and then for the next one, it's going to be negative 5 times positive 22 is negative 110. And you can do that off to the side if you want to check 22 times 5. And then let's see, now we're done with multiplication and it's addition and subtraction from left to right. And so it's going to be negative 18 minus 110, which is negative 128. Okay, so that was a complicated one that involved a lot of different types of operations. Let's try another one like that. Okay, let's evaluate negative 6 minus bracket 2 minus the absolute value of 3 minus 15, end of absolute value, end bracket all over negative 4 squared. Okay, now the first thing is this, is that I see a giant fraction bar. Okay, and the way we think of that giant fraction bar is kind of like this. You have something in the numerator divided by something in the denominator. Okay, so that symbol right there, that big fraction bar, is like the division symbol right there. It's telling you, hey, this is your numerator up here. All of this is your numerator, and all of that is your denominator. Now, when you do that, if you write it like this, do you see how there are parentheses around the numerator and parentheses on the denominator? Those are grouping symbols. And the meaning of that is that you can work within these grouping symbols. That is, you can work on this whole numerator separately, and you can work on the denominator separately. So whatever stage you're at in GEMDAS in the numerator, that's totally independent from whatever you're doing in the denominator, okay? And that's the meaning of this giant fraction bar. You can work on these independently. So let's do that. Let me first look at the numerator. Now, I'm applying GEMDAS, right? And I see that I have brackets, and those are grouping symbols, but I also have the absolute value. And the absolute value are grouping symbols as well. So remember how it goes. Within these grouping symbols, you apply GEMDAS, and I apply GEMDAS to this, and then I see here another set of grouping symbols. So I would focus on the innermost grouping symbols first, right? The absolute value. Within that, it's subtraction. So it's 3 minus 15. And that's how it always goes. When you have grouping symbols within grouping symbols, you always do the innermost, you focus on the innermost grouping symbols first. So let's see, 3 minus 15 is negative 12. That's the only thing that's going to change. So here we go, in the numerator. So it's negative 6 minus, nothing else has changed, bracket 2 minus, it's still the absolute value of 3 minus 15. We said it was negative 12. Okay, and then extend that, and then bracket. Okay, now what happens in the denominator, that's completely separated from whatever happened in the numerator. So let's see, 4 squared is 16, and then I still have the negative there. Okay, so the denominator is completely taken care of. And notice in the denominator, I was on the E in GEMDAS. That's fine, because what happens in the denominator is separate from what happens in the numerator. Okay, now here, I'm not finished, right? I still have these grouping symbols, the absolute value. The absolute value are kind of special. There's always one last operation to be done. What is the absolute value of negative 12? Well, that's positive 12. So this is going to be negative 6 minus bracket 2 minus, and now I've done this, right? The absolute value of negative 12 is positive 12. So I can just write that down. It's positive 12, and then bracket, and then all over still negative 16. Okay, so now I'm still inside these grouping symbols, right? So it's going to be negative 6, take away. Now usually when there's only one set of grouping symbols, people use parentheses. I used brackets here, but it's fine if you want to change those to parentheses. So you can write parentheses, 2 minus 12 is negative 10, right? And then all over the denominator, which is negative 16, coming along for the ride. Okay, now let's go ahead and finish that problem up here. So the numerator, we're subtraction, right? Or we are subtracting. So we're subtracting a negative. And to do that, we change that to positive. So boom, boom, it becomes negative 6 plus 10. And then all over negative 16. And then finally, negative 6 plus 10 is 4 divided by negative 16. And finally, a positive divided by a negative is a negative. And you can reduce 4 over 16 to give 1/4. So that's my answer, negative 1/4. Okay, so this was a good example using many different types of operations. And the order, you have to be really careful. And the secret, of course, is just simply writing everything from left to right, taking things one step at a time. Okay, until next time.